Okay. I'll just send my. So you, my guest, is all. So here, the Rutika, my guest, is here, and I'm expecting. Hello to everyone. Welcome to Perfect Women, India's first talking magazine, and I'm here. Yes, we'll be joining and. Yes, Ashok ji. Depression is the main cause and main topic for today. Hello, and welcome, Rutika, to Perfect Women, India's first talking magazine. It's a pleasure to have you.
Hi, how are you, Dr. Krishi?
Very fine. How are you, sweetheart? You tell me.
It's your day. I'm doing well. Thank you.
That's interesting and wonderful. Sweetheart, I just wanted, since you are the perfect woman for today and there is a lot of story within you. So today I want you to share your journey. How did you begin? How was your childhood?
Childhood, I was a very introvert person. I am still a very introvert person. So it was very quiet. I've been a topper in my class. And then, you know, I was also... school captain and, you know, red house, blue house captain and everything. So, yeah, it was simple, very studious kid, not many friends. So, it was just that. And, yeah, so my childhood was just books and books.
So, what made you to step into fashion world and all about entertainment?
So, what happened is I used to do a lot of work. My dad is a businessman and I've always wanted to do business. But my uncle was a director, Mr. Kundan Shah, if you've heard of him. He's a maker of Kabhi Haan Kabhi Na, Fauji, and all those. So, Chachu was doing one of the film and he wanted somebody to assist. And, you know, apparently his assistant got sick. So, he said, would you like to join me for a few days, you know? So, I said, yeah. I mean, what else will I do, you know, after, you know, it's in school and, you know, you don't have much to do anyway. So, I said, yeah, I'll join in. So, I joined him. Yeah, that's the rest is history. That's where the journey began. I loved it so much. I was an assistant AD to him. I was taking care of a little bit of coordinations and stuff, and I loved it so much that I've not.
Okay, so how did you turn yourself towards the advertising and media PR? You had pretty good options to get into Bollywood because you had a stunning personality.
Hello? Me?
Hello. Since you had the stunning personality, why didn't you go ahead with the Bollywood acting career and you opted for media and PR?
I can't really hear you, Dr. Khushi, well.
Yeah. Am I audible to you now? Yeah. So as everyone knows about it, and I know you in person also, you got a stunning personality. So the reason behind choosing media and PR rather than getting into acting world was?
I never wanted to be into acting, you know. I always like to be behind the camera and that's where I love to be. I can't be the one who's facing the camera. That's not my capacity, but... Yeah, I love being behind the camera. I love managing artists. I've been managing a lot of artists, a lot of celebrities in my entire career. You know already, we've done a lot of work together as well. That's the forte. That's my area, brand building, positioning, PR activities, managing PR for them, handling work for them. I think I'm very happy in that space.
So since you are a part of this advertising and PR world for past decade, it's almost more than a decade, I believe now.
Yeah,
so how
yeah.
has been your experience so far?
Oh, I love this industry. The more we grow into it, the more I'm loving it. Things have changed drastically since the time I started. It was very unorganized earlier. It has gone very organized now. A lot of things are black and white and, you know, little gray area. Of course, gray is there in every industry. Nepotism and everything is there in every industry. But what used to be earlier to now, it's way better. And I think it's only going to be better now.
I completely agree. So, like, since my people are also waiting for a demand, so what is better for these days, like print media or social media?
Social media, any day.
So, like, the reason behind it, how can a person brand the person's product, or maybe possibly any brand or any herself, herself also, how to product herself into advertising for social media?
See, right now everybody is on digital platform, right? Even with this 3 to 4 months of lockdown, I think each of us survived because of digital marketing and social media.
Absolutely. So
it is the place to be. There are a couple of ways to, you know, promote yourself. Is the way I do it is mine is a little more personal profile. At the same time, in between, I keep talking about my work because I want to keep it personalized. And, you know, we do a lot of celebrities, so we want to keep that juggle on. For a lot of individuals like you or a lot of celebrities themselves, it's a very good platform to showcase themselves, to showcase their talent, because every day you can't be going out and auditioning, correct? You don't have that opportunity every day. But one platform where you could be seen by not just your directors, producers, but also a lot of fans of yours. So it's the place right now, and lot of brands are also enrolling on you know, digital platforms. A lot of them are doing paid campaigns, a lot of collaboration, shout outs. So I think it's the place to be, and you know, you have to be more and more serious about it. It's not like aapne pizza khaya. Instagram, Facebook is no more like aapne pizza khaya uska photo dala. You know, Absolutely. You're getting my point. You have to be very strategic in terms of what kind of content you are putting out. You have to think through that whatever you are doing, whatever profession you are in, it kind of gives out those messages to your, you know, followers or your people who are liking it or following your page. You know, that content is very important. And if you are good on your content front, you are there. The game is all there.
I completely agree. And when it comes to branding, as you have been an expert and you can say branding queen, you have been branding so many brands. So yes. What is the strategy behind each campaign you do?
See, my one major strategy in India specifically is one-on-one connect. So whether it's an individual brand or it's a brand which has a product or something which they want to sell, I try to build an emotional connect with my audiences for all my brands. That's where my target is, and that's where we all brands should look at, because Absolutely. If you are unable to build a trust with your consumers, if you are not able to build that connect, your consumer is not going to come back to you. So it's never about one sale for me. It is about doing one sale and then having recurring sales via it, you know. So all my clients and brand strategy is very clear that, you know, it's not just one time. So if anybody comes to me with a short-sighted vision, I'm the one agency who says no to clients. And I have said no to a lot of clients, because for them, when, you know, it's about PR also, they think PR is a sales strategy. And it happens with biggest of the celebrities, okay? I've worked with biggest of the celebrities, and I know their show so short-sighted that, you know, they want to really think ke, okay, maine ye PR activity ki, to mujhe isse 10 sales aana chahiye ya 100 sales aana chahiye. But PR, you know, PR is not like that. PR is more about positioning yourself and building that connect. And same way when it comes to social media also, you can't do a campaign for 1 month and see how things are performing. You have to, it's an investment. So you have to spend 1 year, 2 years, 3 years behind building patience. That entire thing. It's a patience work. It can't be something which you are like, did it for 1 day and then, you know, you are finished. You need results in 1 month. 1 month, you can analyze what is working and what is not working. But, you know, and on that, you can keep changing your strategies. But it's not the only parameter that in 1 month, no agency is coming up with a magic wand, you know. Ki aapne chhadi ghumai aur results aa gaye, you know. And the ones who do it, they are using all those artificial methods of bots and everything. So that's it.
Understood to your point. These are the basic strategies one has to follow. So according to you, how important is PR, publicity and advertising in today's world?
See, like I said, you have to build a connect. So one is you engage yourself into the marketing activity. So marketing happens in various mediums. Chahe aap print mein advertise kar lo, aap social media active ho jao, you are running on paid ad campaigns and everything. But what is better is someone else putting in a word for you. And that's where PR comes in. Correct.
Right.
Like, because you have worked with me, you've called me to come on live with you. Right. That's my PR right. with you. We know each other for right. a very long time, you know. But
absolutely,
this is how we are utilizing. This is what the PR is all about. So it may not result you in an immediate basis. It may not give you any conversion on an immediate basis. But it's a long-term process where you are building your positioning, where you are building your identity in front of your consumers. And when they have that kind of an opportunity, or when they think, you know, they think of you for the first time. So that's how the PR is.
I am really valuable points have been noted here. Now, coming back to you, since we are talking about you, I know you for years today, and I've seen you coming out of many ups and downs of life. So yes. since this month is all about depression, and so I would like to know more about what is your say and your take on the word depression.
I'm very sensitive to that word because, like you said, you've seen me and I have been through depression and I have come out. Unfortunately for me, it was like that I didn't have anyone around. My dad was busy. My mom is a homemaker. So, you know, she doesn't really have that knowledge of depression. And in our society, if you say someone that, okay, mujhe depression hua hai, my dad itself, arre ye sab kya hota hai? Khao, piyo, mast raho. You know, that kind of thing. But they don't take that thing in a serious manner that you want to go and attend a therapist and take an appointment. So I didn't go that route, of course, because even I didn't have a good notions about mental illness because I was not that well versed with depression myself when I had this thing. So how I struggled was I got myself involved into a lot of spiritual activities. I read a lot. I got into spiritualism, quantum physics, and I got myself into meditation. I used to read tons and books. I would read and listen to a lot of failure autobiographies because I think a lot of people read successful autobiographies, but I think success story to sabko achhi lagti hai, but failure nobody wants to hear it, you know. And that was my key area where I learned a lot of people where they failed, and that kind of gave me motivation that, you know, these people can also fail. You know, there is a bad thing happening to each and every one of our lives. You don't have to give up. You know, jaise hum car mein travel karte hain, you get a signal, right? So you stop.
Right.
So that does not mean that you are not going to move forward. You will move forward in your life, right? You will move forward to your destination wherever you are heading in your car. So such is life, that whenever you get a red signal, just stop, have patience, take a deep breath and wait for the signal to turn orange and green and move forward.
Wow, wow. Now, these are very important steps one has to follow because, and this is what the main today's motto is, because when it comes to depression, there are people who don't want to take any action. Their anxieties yes. and their pain and their grief within themselves takes them towards the path which is not acceptable for us also. So since you went through all these things, so how was your experience? How much time it took for you to come out of it?
It took me 4 years to come out of it, to be very honest. I had become suicidal. See, depression, it's very dark, you know. It's very, very, very dark. You self-isolate yourself. You destroy everything that is around you. I remember I had set up a successful business and I ruined it all, you know, because I was suffering to depression. I ruined everything. For 4 years, in that 4 years period, I kept losing clients. I would not pay attention. I would get moody. I would not attend events I was supposed to. I had friends who wanted to, you know, go out with me and hang out with me. And I would isolate myself. So it is a very dark space. And no matter how much ever we say ki tumhare friends, family se baat karo, aapko nahi chahiye aap kisi se baat karo. You don't want to talk to anyone. you know, you don't want to tell anyone because you think nobody understands your pain. And that's the deepest level and the darkness level of depression, that you feel that nobody understands you no matter whatever you want to say. So in the end, it's all about you, only you. I have reached to a point where I had almost wanted to cut my, you know, hand, and then I stopped because I was like, dude, I can't do this. I don't want to do this. You know, I got so scared. I just stopped myself. And then since that day, I changed my life and I said, listen, I'm going to swap myself out. I am going to, you know, focus on only good things. So I would maintain my journals. I would, you know, start writing blogs. So I have my blog. I write a lot of shairis and poems. So, you know, whenever I get in that emotional zone, I switch myself creatively and, you know, completely save myself. Because ye lockdown hai, I know a lot of people are having anxiety. I also had anxiety in between last week. And I immediately called my friend and I said, look, dude, I'm not feeling well. Just talk to me. I don't care whatever condition you are. Poor girl was at 2 o'clock at her home. She was fast asleep and she spoke to me for 2 hours, nonstop listening to me. So, you know, sometimes you have to do those activities and, you know, speak to people. I know you don't want to do it, but you have to do it just to get out of that zone, you know, because it's a very tiny line, you know, it's a very, very, very thin line. You never know when you'll cross it. And when you cross it, it's all over, you know.
Right. So when, since the readers also, I'm just reading the comments below. So yeah. People who are into these depression and they, what step they have to take to come out of it? Because the shyness is always there. They are unable to speak to. They don't have people who listen. Because today's in our India, you know, this is the far most thing where people will, very first thing is, okay, this is something I don't want to, this is not done. Aisa nahi hota. So for those people who don't have anybody to listen and probably who don't even want to share their grief to anybody. So what is your opinion for them?
See, right now, still, I would say it is a lot better situation when it comes to mental illness and depression. So people are now, you know, giving a compassionate hand ahead. They are helping you out. But I think all you can do is please approach the right doctors, the therapist. Approach only therapists who are certified and have years of experience. Please do not approach any therapist who are with just 5-6 years of experience, because it's not going to help you. You need somebody who has done this for a longest period of time, or someone who knows what they are doing. Because I've seen off late when I was talking to a couple of friends of mine, and you know, I happened to come across one therapist, and I was like, dude, she knows nothing about depression. Mm-hmm. She knows nothing because she's like us, you know. हम कितना भी एडवाइस दे देंगे किसी को भी, वी आर नॉट द डॉक्टर्स इन द एंड, वी आर नॉट द थेरेपिस्ट. सो आवर वे ऑफ हैंडलिंग वर्क इज ऑल टुगेदर डिफरेंट. दिस थेरेपिस्ट हैव बीन ट्रेन्ड देमसेल्फ टू रीच टू द रूट कॉज ऑफ द डिप्रेशन, एंड व्हेन दैट कॉज इज रिजॉल्व्ड, योर डिप्रेशन विल बी आउट ऑफ योर सिस्टम. बिकॉज आप डिप्रेशन से बहुत सी चीजें रिलेटेड है, आपका चाइल्डहुड ट्रॉमा हो सकता है, you are hurt at some places, yourself, you know, confidence is not that great, you are nervous about certain things, there are a lot of things in your subconscious mind which you don't even know about, you know, and that may be impacting. When I got to know my root cause, I was surprised. I was like, dude, this is not even possible. So, you know, it is like that. So when you, it is not that ki aapko abhi, आपके पास तो सब कुछ है. लाइक यू नो, फॉर पीपल टॉक अबाउट सुशांत सिंह ऑल्सो, दैट ही वॉज सो सक्सेसफुल, ही हैड एवरीथिंग, ही हैड वर्क, मनी, गर्लफ्रेंड, लव लाइफ, एवरीथिंग वॉज सॉर्टेड, बट स्टिल ही यू नो डिड अ सुसाइड. सो दैट्स हाउ द डिप्रेशन वर्क्स, बिकॉज इट्स ऑल विद इन योर सेल्फ. इट्स वेयर यू आर हर्टिंग, यू प्रोबेबली डोंट नो, इट्स अ सबकॉन्शियस माइंड where you need to remove that root cause, and only a good therapist with good amount of experience.
I completely agree to your words, because these are the points which we miss out in our daily life. But what must be the root cause? What is your opinion for the students who are in depression due to the study material? Because there are students who, for the failure, not accepting their failures. Because initial stage, when you start your career, it is but obvious that you will face everything. You have to taste failure also. So, for what is failure according to you?
Failure for me is nothing but a learning experience. All you have to do is understand where you went wrong, analyze it, and rather than crying over it or not accepting it, accept it that yes, you failed. Say, I talk about my failures very proudly, and a lot of people tell me, dude, you say that you failed in one particular venture and you're saying it so proudly. I've never seen anyone saying, I'm like, there's nothing, I at least attempted to try. Absolutely. I had, I worked towards it. I paid attention. I tried to achieve a dream, which didn't work out. It's okay. Not all ideas are going to be successful, right? Some may fail. Absolutely. Some may get successful. So it's all about learning experience. Learn that, and probably wherever, when you realize that, that learning is always going to help you in your future. Today, if I see what I'm doing right now, a lot of things I don't know right now, but I have learned it in my past failures, which is helping me to make those correct decisions, That's why I'm wise in my decisions when it comes to business or, any tie-ups or, tackling any challenges in my business. So every failure is an experience and it's an award. You have to keep in mind that way.
Absolutely. And what is success according to you?
Success is nothing. Yeah. Success is absolutely nothing. Because the minute you get successful in one thing, your target changes. So you move on to the next success level or next goal, So success is nothing but just a journey in life.
That's wonderful. So now, since we are under the lockdown and the pressure is all over, how are you spending your lockdown days? It's been more than 3 months now.
I have been very busy in my lockdown because, I've been running PR firm and, I have a social media firm.
Yes, yes.
Events are not there, but yes, I have a couple of clients whom I have convinced to, keep the work going on during the pandemic. Because, like I said, I want to build trust for my brands and for myself with their customers. So, if you're not supportive of them and you are not doing a marketing activity because the pandemic is there, you're again losing out on the connect which you have built in so many years with your consumers. And you're getting disconnected in the time when they most needed you, So again, that again does not go with all the clients. Of course, certain can't do it and certain industry won't be able to do it, which is fair. And they shouldn't do it also. But some clients especially a lot of celebrity clients can definitely do it because it is their time to be seen. It's their time because everybody is on digital platform. There are a lot of directors, producers, casting agents, everybody is up there. And if you are a celebrity and you are not active, on the social media platform, you're not doing any justice for yourself. So I've been very busy, luckily. Touch wood,
blessings. So apart from this, any activities or any hobby you adopted in this lockdown?
Yes, I've learned cooking. I used to hate cooking. I mean, I've never entered kitchen in my life. I don't like cooking, at all. But this pandemic has made me like cooking a lot nowadays.
Oh, wow, that's amazing. So your mama is happy now?
Yeah, my mom is happy.
That is. Now, like Rituja, coming towards your part, since I have seen your journey and we have been discussing about all pandemic and depression and everything. So now, what are your, apart from, if not PR, probably if not advertising, where would I have been seeing you? What would I have been your chosen firm?
Very hard to tell, I have always dreamed to do this and I am doing it. I don't have a plan B and I never have plan B in my life. I always have a plan A and I make sure I attend my plan A. There's no plan B.
Now, what would be your advice to all the people who are running their depression and right now, not just about, there are many students for their failings in their news, in their papers, in the examination, the assessments. So what is your advice for those teenagers?
advice to especially students,
yes,
please, all the teachers, don't hold me for this, but all I'm going to tell is marks, degrees do not matter at all. They're genuinely, it's just a piece of certificate, and that's about it for you to get a better promotion or a better, you know, higher figure to reach to the top level of management. But whatever you do, you make sure you are loving it. You are not bored. You are going to office and you are not cribbing about it that, oh, fuck, I have an office. I've seen a lot of people who are like, Monday hai yaar, office jana padega. And trust me, I don't like those people because I get super excited about Mondays and heading to office. So all I want to say is don't worry about your marks. Don't worry about, you know, you failing your exams or anything, because if you failed in one place, you will succeed in another place. You just Absolutely. Have to look within yourself as to what you really want to do it and go for it. That's it.
Astonishing. Astonishing. And secondly, coming towards it, this is the really one nice and okay. So when it comes to, apart from this, since we heard about from you that you're more about into spirituality, so what spiritual advice you can give it to others?
All I want to say is right now, meditate. Okay. Right now, all you need is, because there is a lot of anxiety, lockdown hai, calm nahi hai, money is not coming in. Even though I'm busy, but none of my clients are paying me right now. So I have a backlog of 6 months where a client has not paid me, you know. So that will happen. But stay very focused. Have a balanced mindset. And you to have that balanced mind, you need to meditate. You know, at least start meditating for half an hour to 1 hour's time. There are a lot of apps. Go on YouTube. Probably they'll help you with. There are a lot of videos on, you know, meditation. Start with meditation. Do affirmations. Affirmations are the positive thoughts which you send out in the universe. And I always, if you seen my Instagram page, you'll always see some Listen. Or the other quotes. A lot of hashtag that says universe has your back. You know, trust your destiny. Trust your universe. Just whatever you want, talk to your angels, talk to your universe, saying that, you know, I want this in this timeline. So you have to be very specific when it comes to manifestations. I am very specific to my manifestations. I make it time bound that within this period, I want this thing to happen. How it happens, it's not your lookout. It's like you go to a restaurant. It's like you go to a restaurant and you're ordering a food. And you tell the waiter there that, listen, I want to have one, let's say, triple Szechuan rice, you know.
Okay.
You don't care how the chef is going to make it, what ingredients is going to put in it. Except for certain things which you are allergic to it, you mention it to your waiter that, you know, I don't want this thing, but rest everything is fine. Same way goes on with the manifestations, you know. You have to be very specific what you want, and they will help. To, you know, the universe is going to help you get that manifestations on your table as soon as things are fine. The minute you stop thinking about how and why, it will come to you.
So these are the important factors, because these days, earlier there wasn't that meditation. Okay, Gautam Buddha used to meditate. We used to listen to the stories, but we have implemented in our life now in these days. And I believe in the pandemic, everybody has adopted it as a hobby also. So this is something very nice for today's generation, adopting a power that is divine power. It is definitely going to help for everyone. Now, since I see you always fit and fine, what is your fitness mantra?
I'm the wrong person to talk about fit, because I don't work out. I don't do any exercise. I know, which is a very wrong thing. But I somehow can't work out. And I'm just a happy person myself. I try to be as much happy as I can, as much optimist as I can. And I think that's how I live my life. Yeah, I mean, I don't need to really bother about.
But I cannot give this advice to others.
You can definitely tell them to be, you know, happy. That's the core of your essence.
And okay, that's wonderful. So for people who have been observing Rutuka, it's very clear you just have to be happy. Otherwise, everything is fine. Even if you don't work out, it's fair enough.
Yes, totally.
Wonderful. And how have you been maintaining your beauty? Because I see you, your skin texture is amazing. So what is that beauty from the kitchen you have adopted? Kindly share it with us.
Yeah, I mean, I do those things for sure because my mom is alive. So I usually have orange peel. So when you are done eating orange, you have those peels, right? So I usually, dry those orange peels and then crush them and use it with honey or raw milk and apply it all over my face. It's the best detan and thing. And second, of course, Mohit Arora is here. So I eat Diet and Taste, lovely food. Diet and Taste is a friend's restaurant that's completely into healthy diet food.
Diet.
So, and it's not too bland, you know. When you think of diet food and, you know, you think that, oh, it's only about salads and no masalas and all that. But anybody who wants a healthy diet food and still is chatori like me, then please go and talk to Mohit Arora from Diet and Taste. I think he'll help you to reach your body type the way you want it. We have been catering to a lot of celebrities already. So he's the king in Diet and Taste and healthy food.
Wonderful. And what about, like, since you have been guiding everyone, you are good at writings, you have been a good blogger also. So people who are more, you can say, who are fascinated to be a writer, what's the tip for them?
Writing is no tip. Yeah, there's always, for me, what I write is, I write two kind of things. One is because I'm a publisher of a magazine. So one is completely on a business angle, where we talk about brand extensions and royalties and licensing, merchandising line, you know, limited edition collections. So that is one business aspect of it. On the personal aspect of it, I am talking completely about the journals that I have, the blogs I write is whatever comes to my heart. I just pour myself. I don't care if anybody is reading it or not reading it. It's purely for me to, vent myself out. Talent not talent and all. It's mainly I want to, you know, just express myself. So whatever words keep flowing when I write, I've never edited a single block in my life. So us waqt jo dimag mein aaya wo likha hai, and that's how I publish it. There's never rereading towards it.
Wonderful. Okay, Rutuja, coming back again towards you, you are a blogger. Now, when it comes to travel, which is your favorite travel destination?
My favorite travel destination is Vegas. I love Vegas. I've been going from last 6 years every year. Also because it has my business events and all there. So I usually make sure my business trips are clubbed with my pleasure trips. So vacation at the same time you do your business activities. So Vegas is my favorite place. Then I move around. We rent a car and, you know, we do a road trip. And from Vegas to LA to, you know, go to Miami and South California, Anaheim, Disneyland and those places. But I love Vegas. The energy and everything is superb.
Though you are a chatori, what is your favorite food?
I love Pani Puri a lot. A lot. Like, I can literally eat Pani Puri every day.
Well, okay. Now, talking about perfect woman, who is your perfect woman in your life?
My mom.
Wow. So, how would you express that? How she has been your support system?
Yeah, mom has been very supportive all throughout my life. Yeah, I mean, she gave birth to me. That's one of the biggest things that can ever happen. And I'll be forever grateful for... there'll be always an immense amount of gratitude for that, because if she wouldn't have given me a birth, I wouldn't have been here and I wouldn't have been doing anything what I'm doing right now. So that's it. And my mom is a great cook. And that's it. I mean, if she just loves everyone and she loves to feed people and I love to eat. So this lockdown, I'm trying to be a little like her and, you know, learn a bit of cooking and feed my parents.
Right. Being a woman, like, what is your advice? What if you would have been given a chance to empower womanhood? What would have been that?
I'm saying I don't think women needs any kind of empowerment. We are very strong. Okay, if we can bear the pain of having a child, carrying a child for 9 months and then giving a birth to that child, which is as painful as having a heart attack and dying of it. But so we don't need any empowerment. All we need is one woman to be more supportive of another woman. If we can do that, I think we have enough.
Absolutely. So these are the best words and best quotes by Rutuka. Thank you so much for being a perfect woman. Last but not the least, what is your advice and your wishes for My Perfect Woman magazine?
You are doing a great job. You are a perfect woman yourself. Whatever you've been doing, all the work, you know, the magazine, and now that the Talking Magazine is finally coming into the successful mode, which I'm really happy because we met when it was just an idea, you know.
Idea.
So I'm really happy. I'm really happy with what you're doing. And I wish all the readers to please subscribe and listen to Khushi Ji. She is marvelous in what she does. And she is also one of my ideal perfect women.
Oh my God, you are my perfect woman, darling. You are such a talented. I see you because it's really important when a young girl does so many activities, having so much feather in your cap, not just one. You are already blocked into a number of acting, from being an entrepreneur to a publication, to a blogger, to a brand expert, to a celebrity manager. So handling these many things all together under one shelter is very difficult. And being a woman, what you're doing, that is called an empowerment. So we as women, we all lift each other. I see your success in your hands. So it's very nice to have you today as My Perfect Woman. And from me and my team, our best wishes are always there for you and your future endeavors. Thank you. And I again, thank you so much for being a part of Perfect Woman.
Thank you so much, Khushi. It's my pleasure and my honor to be part of this life. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sweetheart. We will be joining you again soon for the next session. And that will be for, not for the depression, but yes, how to gain out of everything. So that will be our next session. Okay. Thank you so much.
Definitely. Thank you. Thank you. Bye. Okay.
Bye. Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for being my readers, my viewers, and your support system has always been the backbone for me. So again, thank you, and I'm waving everyone, thanking everyone. My gratitude, please accept. It's too exhaust. Okay, hi. Okay, again, now thanksgiving, my gratitude towards everyone.